You're watching another episode of ESPN Quick Info on the ball with me, Akash Chopra, and I have the privilege of being in the company of Muthaiah Muralidharan. Welcome to the show, Murali. Great era of cricket. You've been a part of a fantastic era of Test cricket, and this conversation is now going to be about champion versus champion. So, Muralidharan, a champion bowler bowling to a champion batsman. Who were the batsmen that actually troubled you, where you felt that they're reading you from the hand and you had to really think hard to dismiss them?
See, I can name few, but only thing is I believe on the day. Hmm. Some batsmen really trouble me because on the day sometimes they come in, they get up in a good mood and everything goes for right for them. Whatever I try, it doesn't go right for me. So, right. On the day, there were so many batsmen has troubled me and they have got hundreds, double hundreds. I can't remember anybody got three, double three, only Shehwag missed 300, I think, against us. So many batsmen, you can't name it there, right? For me, it was so difficult to bowl two people. I felt, because there are a lot of people where I played. One is Brian Lara. Mm-hmm. And the Virendra Shehwag. So these two players played because Virendra is something he understood what I'm bowling, and you that day we discussed how he wants because your teammate and you know what he says. Right. He said he didn't read it, but he played in a different manner, and that suits him and he did. But Brian, I can remember one story I can tell about Brian. Brian was batting because he's getting double hundreds, hundreds, and team is losing. Because I'm taking a lot of wickets, and what he did is in SSC, I think it's I can't remember the year that Brian got double hundred there, but they lost by innings, I think, still. And he was playing brilliantly. And one stage, I was Marwan was there. Marwan is very clever. Marwan is clever means Marwan knows how to. Bat for spin is one of the best players of spin I ever bowled to. So he was in mid-on and said, Marwan came to me and said, okay, now this guy is wherever. It was turning. It was not turning. It's turning big. I was turning big in SSC. And when he's turning, sometimes with the turn, he was hitting extra cover.
Okay.
With the turn, on the rise, hitting extra cover. How he does, I don't know. Then Marwan said, okay, then he sweeps also. So, he didn't allow me to. I set the field for these things. And he said, Marwan said, okay, get him a challenge. The challenge is take out mid-on. That is the hardest shot for the left-hander to play on drive. So, what you do is, you bowl over the wicket, anti his pads and full, and make him to drive on drives. And whether he will miss it and get it caught in slips or gully or somewhere, he will do a mistake. So, first ball, I bowled and it's a perfect ball. What he did is, straight away, he adjusted himself and played a brilliant on drive. And I thought maybe he did it in a fluke. I bowled 3-4 balls, he hit 4-4s. Same way. Right? So, that kind of a player, because he adjusts his stance and position is very well, more than any other player in the world, he did that. So, and when I asked him and spoke to him, and how are you doing? He said, Murali, I couldn't understand which way it's going to spin. But what he has said, Gary Sobers has taught him when he was playing, when the ball pitched, and what you have to, you position to a straight ball.
Okay.
You think as a, you position yourself to a straight ball and play straight as possible, then you will connect it. So that's what he said. It's unbelievable conversation. When Shehwag is so dangerous, and I told so many players, Mohammad Azharuddin, Salim Malik, sometimes Andy Fla, so many players played me over the, sometimes one time, Gilchrist never did know anything about me what he bowling. One inning he came number 3 and just came out and hit everywhere. He got 150. So it happens like that. So it was difficult when on the day is more important. And I think Brian and Sehwag troubled me more than anyone else.
You know, I want to stay with the Brian for a little longer because that was that one series, right? Played in Sri Lanka where I think he got close to 600 runs or something in just the three test matches. How do you adapt to it when there is a guy at the other end who's got the better of you? You're dismissing everyone at the other end, but here is this genius with a bat in hand and who's perhaps reading you from the hand, and he is his own acknowledgement that he couldn't, but he's still got an answer to whatever you bowl at him. So one idea was, okay, let's leave the mid-on fielder empty. That space is empty. Go for it. He went for it, got four fours. So as a bowler, how did you then come back? What were your other ideas of bowling, going round, going over, changing the pace, bowling lots of gusras? What would you do at that time?
So as a plan, I add to Brian, what we do is, Brian is very hard to get him out. He has to do a mistake. I can't put a brilliant ball and take him out. So what we did is, we have to minimize. I never allow him to score quickly. Right. So when he bows, since that time I want to take a chance, Mavan said, okay, take a chance and give him. So otherwise, I set his field and bowl tight as possible, give one run, two run, try to make a single. But what he did is, even when the car looper was batting other end, and he didn't take a single. He didn't want to expose Carl Looper to me. So like that. Only player he was exposing is Chandrapal. He can play a little bit of spin. Mm-hmm. He didn't understood. And Salwan. So those two. See, West Indies had a very good batting lineup, right? But still, I was running through the side. And also Vaz at the time. And also he was bowling reverse. So we were bowling to tandem. And it was difficult. So it was like we were minimizing. So he gets a double 100, but West Indies scores only 290.
Correct.
So he scores 500, 600. They lost by innings. So that's why he got six innings, about 600, 700 runs. But end of the day, we won all three matches. So one match we played in West Indies. That match, what he did is, when me and Vaz bowling, we can bowl, you have to bowl session 30. We can bowl maybe 20 overs. Vaz will bowl about 6 or 7, and I will bowl 13 overs, right, at a shot. So when Vaz and me bowling, what he did is, he was just playing ones and everything. And when another bowler comes, he takes them to 10s, 15s, and suddenly he goes to 50. Then we come after that, we bowl, he gets slowly to, and when other bowlers come, he goes to 100. He is a mastermind of how he take the lesser bowler, and difficult bowler, he will just make sure once and milk him, and then the lesser bowler comes, he takes 15s and 20s and moves his score. So that's the greatness of Brian Lara.
Only one thing that stands out in this is, for me, Brian Lara, while facing you, he put his ego aside that I might be a champion batsman, but the fact is there is a fantastic bowler at the other end. I'm going to give him respect. But you also did the same, that now I'm going to be defensive. I'm going to just let him be there, not score quickly. So did you actually bowl defensive lines, lens, with an attacking feel? Because that is something that you can do in test cricket more often.
Yeah, what we have is, we have a slip and a short leg, and then catching positions. So those are things. And you stop the boundaries. No, those days we don't put many people in the boundaries. But we'll put the gaps. We will close all the gaps. And if you want good enough, go over the top. Right? Because those days the players who ban and everything, he won't take a chance and go over the top and try to give me a sniff. So what he will do is, he will just place it once and he just plays made overs and everything. And he waits. I can't keep on bowling 90 overs, 45 overs other end. He knows there are lesser bowlers are going to come. And then he takes them in two digits, like, you know, 10s and 15s. And suddenly, he's not scoring lesser. By the time, in one day, he's almost there 150 runs. That's what he wants.
Okay, so that's Brian Lara, of course. But then Virender Sehwag, he was a different kettle of fish, right? Because he's not someone who's going to actually play defensively. He wouldn't back himself to just defend and bide his time against Murli. He would take you on, right? So how different was like in bowling to Virender Sehwag when he was in his form?
See, for Virender Sehwag, we put a little bit of deep fielders because I know he will take a chance. Not like Brian, he won't respect. He will know what to do and he will go from his instinct and he thinks, on my day, I will attack anyone I want. That's his idea. I know him very well. So, what we'll do is we will also try to go defensive team and he makes some mistakes and gives me the wicket. But what the Virender does is he makes sure that I will have only 2 hours of play of mine. I will get 150 runs. Right. That is attitude. And if I play day, I will get 300 runs. So he might get out before after lunch, but he would have scored 150 runs. He's already done the damage. So that is attitude. He might even think 94, 98. Some people who think most of the batsmen in 98, he will try to put two singles again. Within the same one, will try to hit a six.
Correct.
That kind of attitude. He doesn't care whether he get 100 or not.
Right.
He doesn't care. Because he thinks, okay, I'll play the shot. If it comes, it comes. So that kind of attitude of player. So I think they're very difficult. Like Gilchrist also said. Like similar players, these are match winners like Sanath Jayasuriya. So these kind of players is not many players in the world. So their attitude is just go and smash it.
So how do you challenge such sort of a player? So for example, you tried once with Brian leaving that mid-on fielder empty. Would you just do the same with say a Virender Sehwag, leave covers empty? Now play me against the spin. I'm turning big, but you have to cover drive me for a four. Would you do that for him? Would that be a ploy to just tangle the carrot and see how he plays?
For him, I don't do that because what I'll do is I will have a short leg and a slip, okay. But I will put deep fielders. That means to him to risk less shot to play. He's good at playing the risk, taking the risk because no fear, he takes it. So we have to put little bit of fear. Okay, if I miss it, I might get out. So that fear we have to put it. So then you have a longer fielders putting that. That's the way. But when Sehwag played most of the time, sometimes he cheaply got out. Sometimes he made us very, very difficult because got 200s in about in a day. I can remember in Mumbai, he got 290. And next day, I don't know, he told me when he came back, everyone wants to make. So he could have hit 1-4 and made it 300. I think Rahul Ravi told him, hang on, there is whole day tomorrow. You can get. Next day he came and he was trying to just milk me and got a cotton ball, 296. He didn't get. Right. And he was still, if you ask him, he said, I should have not listened to Rahul. I should have just gone after it.
Right. No, excellent. Anybody else? Of course, we've spoken about how was it bowling to say someone like Sachin Tendulkar? Because he is perhaps the most complete, technically most complete, compact with the shots and everything, like a definition of a perfect batsman, a modern batsman. How was it bowling to him? Did you find tough bowling to him or you had a good grip on whatever Sachin had to offer?
See, for Sachin, no fear to bowl because he won't hurt you. That feeling I know because Sehwag can hurt you. He won't hurt you, but very tough to get him out. Because he will protect his wicket. He knows how he watches the... He's a good reader of the ball and everything. He knows the technique and everything. But I felt in my career, Sachin had a small weakness on off-spin.
Okay.
He didn't have leg stance spin or leg spin. He smashes. But off-spin, somehow he had some difficulty because I got him out so many times. And also... lesser off-spinners also get him out so many times I have seen him there. I don't know, maybe it has run in his mind or I don't know. I have never spoke about it because he's a legend. I can't ask why you are not very comfortable with off-spin. I can't say that to him because structure, we can't say that. But I felt in mind he had a little bit of weakness. That's why I got a little bit of advantage more than other players. Sachin is a great player. Very difficult to get him out. But off-spinners had a little bit of sniff on him.
Which batsman, if you were to just pinpoint one, who could read your dusra, Murli? Because that was the toughest ball to actually decipher. Even from the back angle, we couldn't see that, okay, this is an off-spin or this is a dusra because everything came out of that wonderful, supple wrist that you have. Was there a batsman who could read it well?
Sachin definitely read it. Okay. I know. Sachin. I thought Rahul didn't read much.
Okay.
I thought he might. Lakshman read it. Lakshman read it, I think. And players like Gambhir.
Right, okay.
Gambhir read it. Gambhir is a good spin player. And Sehwag, sometimes he read it, sometimes he don't know, but he played with a different technique. So if you take Indian players, those guys who read it, not many people, sometimes they read it 50%. 50% okay. They might not read it and different way, because when I bowl the dusra, I don't use the seam. When I bowl the off spin, also scramble seam, my dear. So with the seam, you can't see my bowling. Only you have to see from the my wrist. So correct. If it's how it's delivering. So it is a little bit hard. And I think it was tough for players. But if you take Sri Lankan players, if you say Sangakkara, Mayala, and Aravinda De Silva, Mavan Athappatthu, but I know Dilshan never had a clue. Never read it. Right. Some other players never read it. But these players, Sangakkara, Mayala, Aravinda, you know. Because, and also, I would say Dhoni read it in the end. Dhoni, I was playing for Chennai.
Okay.
And I was used to bowl. And Dhoni read it. Because I can remember in the World Cup, Yuvraj doesn't have a clue on me. Right? Yuvraj is playing very well in the World Cup final. So, he's supposed to come. I think because of me, Dhoni came.
Right.
To play me. So, that's the advantage he took. But I bowled in Chennai a lot and Dhoni read it more than anyone else. So, that's what these are the things, you know, people go through. And I think few people, you know, foreign soil, not many people will read because foreigners are very hard. They haven't seen bowlers like this hard. But in subcontinent, Pakistan players who read most of the players. But in Bangladesh, not much. Because not many people. Because Bangladesh was not a very good, now is a better side. When we played, they didn't have many good players because they were struggling. So, India and Sri Lanka, Pakistani players read mostly. But not everyone. There are a few people. Most of them read about 50%.
Okay, I've got just one question because this is just riveting conversation, Amurli. When you look at the world right now, the Fab Four, there's Williamson, there is Kohli, there is Steve Smith, there is Joe Root, then there is Rohit, there's Babar Azam, there are quite a few. Do you think that any of these, the new generation players, that you would have actually struggled, maybe found it tougher to bowl to one of these guys or a couple of these guys, depending on or just seeing how they actually play spin in the modern day?
I would say Kohli would have been a tough because I played with Kohli also. Kohli knows me now because so many years, I was 3 years with them and bowling. Kohli is a good player of spin and he understood because especially in test cricket, I don't know about one day cricket, maybe he will go after and might have a chance, but test cricket, he will understand the spin and everything and maybe Kohli. Babar Azam, I never seen, but looks like one of the better players because he's from subcontinent. He's learned in subcontinent, so never very best play. If you think Steve Root, Joe Root, because Steve is different and I don't think I would have been dominating him. Even Joe Root, because he rely on a lot of sweep and reverse sweep. So, I think when doesn't understand the bowling of which way it's going, then only use the receiver, reverse sweep and sweep. It's a risky shot. Whoever playing straight, like, you know, coming line down the wicket and playing straight and mid-on and mid-off. And those players are good player spin. So, I think I would give the choice to these two players will play well.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Murali, for your time and these wonderful conversations. It's an absolute pleasure.